subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chanzong. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 16th of September. Floods triggered by rains disrupt normal life in India's West Bengal and Odisha. Taliban's Baradar says reports he was hurt in internal clash are false. And postponed twice, Nepal Grade 12 examination begins amid COVID-19 pandemic. And now for all the details. Heavy rainfall caused flooding in parts of India's West Bengal and Odisha states, affecting normal life and disrupting movement on Thursday. The disaster management authorities have made preparations in view of the situation, as weather department has forecast rainfall activity to increase over the next 4 days in both the states.
Heavy rainfall caused flooding on Thursday in several parts of India's West Bengal state, affecting normal life and disrupting movement. The State Highway 7 in West Midnapore district was inundated, as few truck and bus drivers risked to drive through the road to reach their destinations despite warnings from police. In Midnapore city, the headquarters of the district, the incessant rainfall inundated several residential areas. The water entered homes and damaged property, causing difficulties for local residents.
पानी अंदर बहुत तेजी से घुस आया है. हम लोग बेड बिस्तर पर बैठे हैं, नीचे नहीं उतर सकते. बहुत गंदा पानी है, पता नहीं कहाँ से आया. यहाँ पर नाला का परिस्थिति ठीक नहीं है, इसलिए पानी अंदर आ गया है.
Meanwhile, rise in water level of Sono River due to incessant rainfall in eastern Odisha state also flooded residential areas in Mayurbhanj district, submerging huts and forcing people to move in thigh high waters. The India Meteorological Department has forecast rainfall activity is likely to increase over Odisha and West Bengal from 18th to 20th of September. The National Disaster Response Force has also deployed its teams in parts of Odisha in view of the flood situation.
In news from Pakistan. Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan, in an exclusive interview with CNN, said the US war against terrorism was disastrous for Pakistan, as Washington used Islamabad like a hired gun during their 20-year presence in Afghanistan. This comes days after US Secretary of State Antony Blinken on Monday said the US would re-assess its ties with Pakistan following the military drawdown from Afghanistan. Blinken told US Congress during a hearing that Pakistan has a multiplicity of interests, some that are in conflict with ours. Pakistan has had deep ties with the Taliban and other outfits in the region. Khan denied charges that Pakistan harbors terrorists and has given them a safe haven. While staunchly defending the Taliban, Khan asked the international community to develop a consensus that would lead the recognition of the new caretaker government of the Islamic Emirate. Khan said that the best way forward for peace and stability in Afghanistan is to engage with the Taliban and incentivize them on issues such as women's rights and inclusive government. The Taliban, since assuming power, has made several assurances on a slew of important issues, including human rights. However, reports coming from the country stand in contrast with the claims. More news from Pakistan. Local residents in Pakistan's financial capital, Karachi, have expressed dismay over recent fuel price hike and inching inflation in the country. Opposition Pakistan People's Party Chairman Bilawal Bhutto Zardari on Thursday rejected the massive hike in petrol prices and said the entire nation is crying due to record inflation while the government has been looting the people. Uncontrolled inflation in Pakistan has broken all records in recent times, and locals are upset with the frequent rise in fuel prices, which has severely hit their domestic budgets. The federal government on September 15 increased the petrol and diesel prices by Rs. 5 per litre each for the second half of outgoing month, due to surge in international oil prices and also Pakistani rupee devaluation against the US dollar. Residents in Karachi city complained pace of inflation is skyrocketing at a time when the economic activity has slowed down and the government is only doing lip service and not keeping in view how people are struggling to earn even their daily bread amid the pandemic.
हुकूमत को ये कहेंगे कि जब वो अपना पेट भर रहे हैं तो गरीब आवाम का भी ख्याल करें, ये जरूरी नहीं कि सिर्फ तुम अपने तिजोरियां भरो और गरीब का ख्याल ही नहीं रखो.
Meanwhile, opposition Pakistan People's Party chairman Bilawal Bhutto Zardari on Thursday criticized the government in a tweet over the recent fuel price hike. He said the incumbent rulers have taken petrol prices to a record high in the country and the entire nation is crying due to the record inflation and the government is robbing its people. In news from Afghanistan, refuting rumors about his probable injury or death, Afghanistan's acting Deputy Prime Minister Abdul Ghani Baradar appeared in a video interview posted on Wednesday, denying reports that he was hurt in a clash with a rival faction of the Taliban. Reports said that Baradar fled to Kandahar following an argument with a cabinet member.
Afghanistan's acting Deputy Prime Minister Mullah Abdul Ghani Baradar appeared in a video interview posted on Wednesday to deny reports that he was hurt in a clash with a rival faction of the Taliban. The brief clip showed him seated on a sofa next to an interviewer with an RTA state television microphone, apparently reading from a sheet of paper. Taliban officials have issued repeated denials in recent days that Baradar, who led diplomatic efforts to reach a settlement with the United States, had been hurt.
نه دا خبره هیڅ حقیقت نه لري. زه الحمدلله جوړ او روغ یم. او بل خبره دا چې رسنۍ وایي چې خپل منځي اختلافات لري، دا بالکل هم هیڅ حقیقت نه لري. لله الحمد موږ په خپل منځ کې ډېر شفقت او ترحم لرو چې حتی په یو فامیل کې به هم داسې شفقت او ترحم نه وي. او بل دا چې موږ دا څو کاله د اشغال د خاتمې لپاره تکالیف او قرباني ورکړي دي، دا نه د اقتدار لپاره وي او نه د منصب لپاره وه.
This comes days after rumors surfaced that supporters of Baradar had clashed with members of the Haqqani Network, a group affiliated with the Taliban based near the border with Pakistan and blamed for some of the worst suicide attacks of the war. Baradar, one of the founding members of the Taliban and once seen as the likely head of a Taliban government, had not been seen in public for some time. He was on Wednesday named in the list of the 100 most influential people of 2021 by Time magazine. Anas Haqqani, younger brother of the Taliban's newly appointed acting interior minister Sirajuddin Haqqani, also issued a statement on Twitter denying reports of internal rifts in the movement.
More news from Afghanistan. Several former and current women football players have fled Afghanistan following the Taliban takeover last month. Afghan youth women's football team players, along with their families, on Wednesday arrived in Pakistan. They will seek political asylum in third countries amid concern over the status of female athletes under the new Taliban government in Kabul.
Players from Afghanistan's female youth soccer teams, along with their families, have arrived in Pakistan and will seek political asylum in third countries amid concern over the status of female athletes under the new Taliban government in Kabul. Some 81 people, including female players of several youth teams, their coaches and family members, reached Pakistan through the Torkham border crossing. Sardar Naveed Haider Khan, a senior Pakistan Football Federation official, said on Wednesday, and some more will arrive on Thursday.
इनको 30 days का visit visa दिया है government of Pakistan ने और total approval 115 का है, लेकिन अभी यहाँ पर हमारे पास 81 जो हैं guests वो पहुँच गए हैं.
Their flight is part of a broader exodus of Afghan intellectuals and public figures, especially women, since the Taliban took over the country a month ago. A former captain of the soccer team urged players still in Afghanistan to burn their sports gear and delete their social media accounts to avoid reprisals. The sports governing body, FIFA, said last month it was working to evacuate those remaining in the country. Earlier, a Taliban representative told Australian broadcaster SBS on September 8 that he did not think women would be allowed to play cricket because it was not necessary and would be against Islam. When the Islamist group last ruled Afghanistan from 1996 to 2001, girls were not allowed to attend school and women were banned from work and education. Women were barred from sports, and that is likely to continue in this government as well.
Moving on to news from Nepal. After being postponed twice due to the pandemic, the annual examination of grade 12 began in Nepal with the physical presence of students in schools on Wednesday, despite rising COVID-19 cases. Over 372,000 students will appear for the exams, which will be conducted until September 24.
Postponed twice due to the pandemic, the annual examinations of grade 12 began in schools across Nepal on Wednesday with the physical presence of students. On the first day, school authorities in capital Kathmandu were seen checking temperature of students and sanitizing before conducting the exams, which will run until September 24. The exam rooms reserved for the examination have individual tables and chairs, and on each bench only one student will be allowed to sit. Over 372,000 students will take the grade 12 exams this year.
As the students enter these examination premises, we have a proper test system where a professional medical person is taking care of their health situation, their temperature. And based on that, they are allowed to come up. But then so far, we've seen that all the students have met the requirements and we've not had any bad or sad story.
Prior to the exams, the students over the age of 18 were vaccinated with anti-COVID-19 doses and the inoculation drive is still underway for them. The mass gathering of students is being conducted when the Himalayan nation has continued to report a surge in COVID-19 cases. As of Thursday, Nepal reported over 780,820 confirmed cases of coronavirus with more than 10,990 deaths so far.
A teacher in a small tribal village in eastern India has turned walls into blackboards and roads into classrooms, trying to close the gap in learning brought on by prolonged school shutdowns in the country and overcome the challenges of lack of internet and electronic gadgets.
A teacher has transformed a remote tribal village in India's West Bengal state by painting blackboards on walls and conducting classes for children on the streets to help overcome the challenges of social distancing and the lack of internet and electronic gadgets. From teaching nursery rhymes to educating about diseases through a microscope, 34-year-old primary school teacher Dweep Narayan Naik is helping village students in Pashchim Bardhaman district who had to drop out due to lockdown, get a second shot at education. India ordered schools to close down in March last year to curb the spread of coronavirus. While many children in cities have been able to learn through online classes, some, like the children in this tribal village, have gone months without opening school books.
यहाँ पर जो बच्चे लोग थे, उन लोगों का हर एक चीज़ यहाँ पर सिखाया गया है कि कैसे सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग मेंटेन किया जाता है, कैसे मास्क पहनना कितना जरूरी है, हैंड वॉशिंग कितना जरूरी है, तो इस मुहिम में बच्चे लोग भी आगे आए, वो लोग भी लोगों को सिखाया।
We all come here for learning. We all very excited about education. Sir, give us book, copy, bags, food.
The reasons for not being able to study online range from not owning a smartphone, having poor mobile connectivity, to not having the money to pay for internet connection. As new infections have stabilized around 30,000 a day in the past few weeks, some Indian states have restarted face-to-face teaching, albeit mainly for middle schools and above.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.